So, good afternoon, Amsterdam. Since no one made any introduction, so we do the introduction by ourselves. I think this is the easiest part. So, we are going to talk about general LoRa use cases in order to solve supply chain issues in logistics.
My name is Alex Raimondi. I'm CEO, co-CEO, together with Schekeb of Miromico, a hardware developing company out of Zurich, Switzerland.
And I'm Schekeb. I'm the second co-CEO of Miromico. And we exist for more than 20 years in the market, well known for hardware production that we do. And we are focusing on the Internet of Things. Next to that, we have a long history in embedded systems design, and we do also chip design. And lately, we have kind of changed our business model, and we went from a pure hardware service provider into products. And we also realized that there is a big market for manufacturing as a service, where we also handle the production, especially when it goes in higher volume for our clients. What we do, actually, we manufacture modules as well as sensors and gateways. And we are not only focused on LoRa, actually IoT is much more and also consists of many different standards. And we think to believe that the future belongs to multi-technology solutions. In particular, during COVID, we realized that supply chain and logistics is fragile. We have seen that while producing our devices globally. And we have also seen plenty of publications in the newspapers on accidents around the globe, which made the logistics even more fragile. And we have also had, we had also situations where we had to ship devices around the globe, supply our manufacturing partners in Asia. And since many different logistics ways did not work in the past, we had to even switch to airplanes in order to transport our devices to our manufacturing partners. And it's not only us in the market, it's actually, as we could observe, whole ecosystems had similar issues. And we were thinking like, it's about the time to actually have a better look how to solve this kind of issues with IoT. And today we are going to present some of our use cases, technologies, or multi-technology devices that can be used in order to tackle these specific problems, since we are talking about the huge potential out there of a market that is not yet digitized as it should be, and there is plenty room for technologies such as LoRaWAN. But we need to understand the business cases behind the logistics and the issues and the problems and the challenges in order to find solutions that are reliable and enable a sustainable and digitized logistics. And why do we do that? Next to having more observability and having a real-time supply and observability on the overall logistics use cases and our shipments, we would like to have also the capability to monitor wherever our material is. And we would also like to have the possibility to find things whenever they are lost, like whenever we landed to Schiphol. The second question was, oh my gosh, in all newspapers, they are reporting about lost bags. So let's hope for the best that we can find our bags again. We were fortunate. We could build our booth. And we need to also have kind of security in our solutions, because we need to have a clue if the material that we bought from, let's say, a certified source is really coming from that source, and that material is not just going to be exchanged. Next to that, we would like to save costs. We would like to optimize the processes and get rid of many costly manual processes. And in order to do so, Alex will take over.
So what are the challenges for IoT in logistics nowadays? So it's, we are talking about global logistics solutions, not just locally. So it means it's going over continents. It goes from, let's say, South America all the way to China, all around the world. So we have the need for a global communication. LoRaWAN, for example, is only working like regional. So we have European frequencies, we have US frequencies. If we use just a plain LoRaWAN, we would have to have devices that can switch between frequencies, which adds to complexity, which we heard in the previous presentation, is not always beneficial for the use case. Battery lifetime is something very important. So all the devices we are adding to our goods are battery operated, which means battery lifetime needs to be at least somehow in sync with transportation times. That can be from weeks up to months, even years. Stuff might be remaining in warehouses for a very long time, and battery have to survive all those issues. We're talking about challenging environments. It's in trucks, it's on sea, it's harsh environment, it's cold, it might get wet, it might get dropped. People are not taking really a lot of care on material that they don't own. So it has to be harsh, it has to be ruggedized. Maybe we also need some kind of localization technology. We need to know where our stuff is. We don't need to pinpoint it down to meters, but we at least need to know, is it still in South America, or has it already arrived in India, or has it gone somewhere else where we don't know, where we don't expect it to be. It also has to be low cost. Logistics is a very low cost, low margin business. So we have a lot of goods, but everything is transported at very low margins. And it's also for the logistics for the deployment needs to be done accordingly. So it's not easy to deploy a logistics system, because we're talking about huge number of devices that all need to be assigned to the right place, that needs to be assigned to goods so that we know what goods we actually are tracking. In most of the cases, if you're talking about adding electronics, which means we add to the cost, the devices might be expensive, so we want to reuse them. In most of the cases, there is no reverse logistics. If you transport something from South America to China, we have all the ways set up to bring the goods there, but there is no in-place reverse transportation, so we cannot bring, for example, the tracker back to the origin source and reuse them. So we have to think about this before we even start to deploy or develop a use case using IoT to support that kind of logistic use case. And another important part is, in logistics, there is always different stakeholders involved. So the one that owns the good is not the one that owns the track, it's not the one that owns the containers. There is multiple stakeholders. All of them could profit from an IoT solution, but in the end, you need to bring them all on board so that they can, in the end, are willing to share even a small part of their margin to deploy or install any kind of IoT solution for the use case. Talk about communication. So there are different technologies we could use for global communication. Sub-G LoRaWAN, for example, or Sub-G wireless transmission, they offer the longest range, so it would be the best way to go if you need long-range communication, but we have issues with global frequency coverage. So we don't have the same frequencies in Europe as in US or even China. So we have high power efficiency, we have no existing networks for those, and there is no worldwide frequency. 2.4 GHz in comparison to that would offer worldwide frequency. We will suffer a little bit of range, but still We have high power efficiency, so this would also be a very good choice. Mobile network, everyone thinks of this would be the way to go if you go for global solution, because there is mobile network all over the world, but there you will face roaming issues. SIM card that's working in Europe, Switzerland, Germany, might not even work in countries like Eastern Europe, or if you go to Africa, you will face severe problems. There are many companies offering global roaming, but try it, it will not work all around the world. You might get it to work, but it will take a lot of work and a lot of testing to make sure you can support global technology, global communication using mobile network. There's new technology also coming up, IoT from satellite. So this is also an area we are heavily exploring, which of course has some benefits, because you can do global communication without having the need for terrestrial infrastructure, so you can have a real global connectivity. But also there, you need to have the right technology. There are different setups, different variations. So before you start implementing your use case, you have to analyze your requirements quite clearly and see what you can do with what kind of technology. In general, LoRa is a good fit. That's why we're also presenting at the LoRa conference, of course. There is worldwide license-free band. Okay, sometimes you have to differentiate between continents, but 2.4 GHz, for example, that can also be used for LoRaWAN communication is a very good choice for that. LoRa provides a superior range if you compare it, for example, to Bluetooth. Bluetooth, of course, is a standard product that can be deployed very cheap, but it will significantly suffer in range if you compare it to LoRaWAN. It needs infrastructure to be installed. LoRaWAN needs gateways. LoRaWAN needs a network. It's not everywhere in the world where we have the situation like in Netherlands or Switzerland, where we have national-wide networks provided by national telecom provider. But in logistics, there is most of the time the entire route could be covered by the freight forwarder, because the route is known, the warehouses are known, so we know where the goods will pass by. So it's given that LoRaWAN has a low cost for infrastructure, gateway costs a few hundred euros, you can install them easily in a warehouse. You can even install two or three without huge investments beforehand. Custom protocols, for example, if we just don't rely only on LoRaWAN, we can extend functionalities, we can add features, we can customize, we can specify. That's the beauty of having LoRaWAN as an open protocol. We can use whatever piece we like to use, and everything else we can still implement using proprietary protocols in the chipsets and in the firmware. 2.4 GHz LoRaWAN, as I mentioned before, it's not yet in the LoRaWAN Alliance standard, but it's easily available for POC, so we can start testing today with LoRaWAN connectivity in a worldwide. And what we are currently working on is a special protocol extension so that we can, for example, mimic UHRFID, which is one of the technologies currently widely used in logistics, with the problem that you always have to build gates or local scanning solution to, for example, scan a truck to implement a solution that scans inbound traffic into a warehouse, outbound traffic of a warehouse. With LoRaWAN, you can easily cover an entire warehouse, but if you do the specialization in the protocol, you can also implement those kind of gate-wise monitoring of the goods. I briefly touched it before. IoT from space, is it an option? For logistics, it will definitely be an option. It's the only system that currently brings real worldwide communication, which doesn't only mean on inhabited areas of the world. We can also have communication or coverage on the sea, which is quite a huge percentage of the Earth only covered by seas. We can have it on very remote location, for example, also for use cases like pipeline monitoring, where an installation of a network wouldn't justify the costs. So we as Miromico, we're working with different satellite providers, satellite partners, and are exploring the different possibilities and options to implement logistics or even other products using satellite connectivity. Another point we need to briefly touch for a logistics use case is localization. So how do we localize our devices, our goods, along the transportation route? First thing that comes in mind is always GPS. Of course, GPS is very handy technology, it's well deployed, it's worldwide available, but it has some issues. First of all, it brings some cost into the device. You always have to have some kind of GPS receiver or any kind of technology that can receive GPS. It will not work inside buildings, so on logistics, the goods are mainly in trucks, mainly in warehouses. They are not very often see open field, so GPS is most of the time, also from power requirements, out of the game. Triangulation, the size of the ball shows the more or less the average accuracy you can achieve. So GPS would be very accurate. Triangulation is easy, it's low cost, but the accuracy is not good enough in some use cases. It might give you the option to see it's in warehouse A or warehouse B, but you cannot locate within a warehouse. As we heard from previous presentation as well, BLE for localization, you can do it quite down to a few meter accuracy because, of course, limited range of BLE now here plays into our hands. And of course, all other kind of Wi-Fi sniffing, for example, other wireless technologies you can use to do localization for your transportation devices. And happily, Semtech has offered us a magical technology solution, I would say. Their LR1110 chip, LR1120 chip, combines a lot of those localization technologies into one chipset, into one solution. It's basically a platform in a chipset. It offers Wi-Fi sniffing, GPS sniffing, and also LoRa in one device. And in the end, you can use their platform to also do the localization of your goods, which means you can add a good selection of localization features into one device at very low cost. We have implemented a few devices that are examples of customer project, of our own project. One is with our national telecom provider, Swisscom. We have developed that value manager. Maybe Schekeb, you want to say a few words about this because you're leading the project?
Yeah, well, our national communication provider kind of challenged us to do the smallest tracking device, which is multi-technology capable and also uses whatever possible technology to get the best accuracy. And after 8 months of the project, we can present today the first results. So the project was a success because what we defined, we achieved. We kind of combined the capabilities of LR1110 with an external GPS and solved it also, kind of combined the Semtech solver with our own know-how. In order to get the precision down to 5 meter outdoor, but also enable the Wi-Fi scanning capabilities to get off kind of a seamless indoor-outdoor tracking solution. So currently, the trackers will be rolled out for alpha clients, and it's fully LoRaWAN compatible. We're currently also working in the background to not only using the multi-technology capabilities of the tracking technologies to combine them to get the best result, but at the same time also combining multi-protocol standards for communications, just that we have the possibilities to have coverage in as many regions as possible. And the best thing in that device is that you can later in the process just replace the LR1110 with LR1120 in order to provide also the satellite communications.
Another device we are just about bringing to mass production is our Miro jacket. It's also an LR1110 based solution. It's purely LR1110, so which means we are using all the features the chip provides, Wi-Fi sniffing, GNSS reception, and LoRaWAN. We just added, for completeness, we added Bluetooth. We can use this for configuration, but we can also use it for other localization features like Bluetooth beacon scanning. We have added buzzers. We have, of course, fully LoRaWAN standard compliant, and we are tightly integrated with the LoRa cloud solution provided by Semtech. The other device I briefly touched is our new product where we do what we do for logistic tracking. It's an optimized tracker, also based on partially L1110, but it has the capabilities to also mimic features like UHF RFID, so that we can provide warehouse inbound outbound traffic and also warehouse stock management features to our customers, with the target to go very low cost in the device, because if you go for a large scale logistic use case, the device cost of each tracker has to be as low as possible. To give everything a little bit a better touch, we have developed kind of an artificial use case to explain all the details a little bit in more, a little bit wider. So we assume there is a coffee company called Green Bean. They produce coffee somewhere in South America, and they want it to be transported to the end user in Europe or in, all around the world. So what we need to know is that the coffee from those farmers, which are growing organically, they're getting a little bit better paid because they have the extra effort to grow everything organically, do it environmental friendly. The end customer that is willing to pay more for that coffee also wants to know that the coffee actually is coming from those plants and not from the cheap plant next to that. So we can use IoT to implement such a case. And of course, once we have this installed, we can also use IoT to add extra sensors, extra monitoring to the shipment. Coffee is a good example. There is like 8,000 bags of each 60 kilos being shipped around the world in an annual volume. So this is showing also the volume or the size you can gain with a logistics use case. So how is this going to happen? At the farm, we have the farmer filling up the bags. They will tag it. They will register the tag in some IoT backend so that we know that this bag that has been tagged at this farm is actually now is a known bag in our system. Now along the entire transportation route, we can pinpoint down where the bag is. We can see that it has arrived in the first warehouse, and it goes to the harbor, then it goes on the ship, and it will arrive at the destination harbor, and finally it will end up in the roastery where we finally process the beans. And all along the way, we can still check that the bag is from our side, it's known to us, we can track it down. And we can also do warehouse inventory, so we can optimize all the warehouse supplies. We can see that maybe a bag didn't make it to the next ship, which actually sometimes is happening, because nowadays with priorities in all the supply chain, the one that pays more money will get the empty space on the boat. So some bags might be left behind, and we can track it on a bag level to see that maybe a pallet or a few bags just didn't make it to the next transportation. To even improve the solution, we can add sensors, so which means we can see that the coffee always has been treated with the right environmental conditions, so it's not too humid, not too dry, temperature has been right. If not, we can either, if still possible, we can act preventively and see that the bag's getting stored in proper condition. If this is not possible because of reaction time or not having real-time data, we can at the end we could reject the bag in quality control and always ensure the goods are arriving in a good condition with our end customer.
Well, saving the cost is one of the issues of global logistics, but in the end we want to get also more sustainable, and one of the goals that we are following at Miromico, we want to actually develop in newer technologies in order to tackle some of the other global problems that we currently have. We are working with suppliers or with startups that are already working with recyclable plastic. Because whenever a pallet with coffee leaves, let's say, farming company or a coffee supplier in South America, and comes to the warehouse in Europe. So what happens with the sensor? Normally they trash the sensor, no one is going to send them back. And it creates actually lots of challenges. So we have to think as a hardware manufacturer or hardware designing company, how to ideally design sensors that can be reused in a way that in the end does not change the cost structure and make the business cases still valid. And next to that, we are investing in use cases that are batteryless, that are using harvesting technologies in order to be fully autarkic. And how to enable that, there are already technologies around. As you can pass by the booths, you will see plenty of solar cells. And we think to believe that this can also be used in a multi-technology way, that you can kind of combine all different energy sources in order to provide the necessary, the essential required power. So next to Amsterdam, you have also chances to speak with our experts around the globe. We will be next month in Dubai at GITEX Global. In November, we will be in Munich and Barcelona. Then December, we will be in Vegas at the AWS reInvent conference or event. And don't forget, since we are based in Zurich, we have also the IoT Visions in Zurich. I hope to see many of you guys there as well. And we are at the booth B17, in case if you have use cases or questions and you want to talk about businesses or challenges in your businesses, then please come and talk to us. Thank you.
Thank you. It's just you and me right now.